Hello children. Children, in this session we are going to continue with this chapter on evidences in history and sources of history. So evidences means the proofs that we have regarding our historical knowledges, whatever historical facts we have, whatever studies we can do regarding our history. So whatever we are able to know about our past, how do we come to believe in those things? Either we should have some proofs, some evidences regarding it, and what are the evidences that make us believe that yes, this thing happened in the past? So we were studying about all the sources of history, and we have come up to the archaeological sources of history. And on this archaeological sources, it is about the study about the human history and prehistory through the excavation of sites. The archaeologists who actually study about the facts regarding history, what do? They go to the locations, they find that there must be hidden something. So they excavate it, so they dig it down, dig the earth, and they find out there are some important facts about the people who had lived during that age, and they then verify it. Then they analyze the artifacts that they get and the other physical remains that they get from the excavations. They prove it that yes, this type of an incident or this type of peoples must have been living in those days. So under this archaeological sources, we have learnt about the inscriptions, that is the engraved things that the people during those age used to engrave or used to write something or carve something on either stones or metals. So these engravements are called inscriptions. So due to this engravements or inscriptions, we know that a lot of things that used to happen in those days were written in these inscriptions, and these writings and these facts then tell us what actually was in that age. Then on the basis of these contents, inscriptions have been classified as administrative, religious, commercial, literary, donative and commemorative. So these have been discriminated into all these different types. That is, the inscriptions were found during the age of Ashoka. Ashoka used to just engrave things on stones or metals, and his engravements actually tell us about everything that happened in his times. Then we have the coins. So when trade prevailed in those days, then special coins were made just to exchange goods for goods. So goods for in place of coins. Previously, what people used to do, the barter system followed, and in this goods were exchanged for goods. But later on, when this was found difficult, this was a difficult thing to carry on for long. So what did the rulers do? They used to just find out. They made coins of either bronze, silver or gold to exchange goods and continue their trade relations with other territories. So this collection of coins by the archaeologist is called as numismatics, and coins serve as the more reliable source for reconstructing our past. So whatever past we believe in or we think about it, it is mainly all because of these coins, because these coins prove a lot about the age. Then we have learnt it is about the Veena, that the coins of Samudragupta depict this, tell us that yes, Samudragupta loved to play the Veena. Now children, in continuation with this archaeological facts, we will now continue the chapter and we'll study how the monuments have proved to be an archaeological source of history. So any building, statue or structure of historical significance is called a monument. So whatever old structures that you find in different places, they आर्ट्स आर द दे आर नोन एज द मोन्यूमेंट्स बिकॉज दे हैव हिस्टोरिकल इम्पोर्टेंस इन इट. सो इट मे इंक्लूड टेम्पल्स फोर्ट्स पैलेसेस स्टूपर्स मॉनेस्ट्रीज एट्सेट्रा. सो इट इंक्लूड्स ऑल दीज थिंग्स द मोन्यूमेंट्स दीज आर ऑल द मोन्यूमेंट्स ऑफ हिस्टोरिकल इम्पोर्टेंस. सो मोन्यूमेंट्स जनरली रिवील इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द आर्ट आर्किटेक्चर रिलीजन एंड द सोशल एंड इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन ऑफ द पीपल इन द पीरियड ऑफ देयर कंस्ट्रक्शन. सो दीज आर द दोज फैक्ट्स दैट टेल अस अबाउट द आर्ट्स ऑफ दैट एज द आर्किटेक्चर रिलीजन एंड द सोशल एंड इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन ऑफ द पीपल ड्यूरिंग दोज पीरियड. For example, the excavation of Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, like as you know, the Indus Valley civilization, the excavation in the Harappa and Mohenjo-daro area, they tell us a lot about the Indus Valley civilization, how the people lived there, what kind of utensils they used to use and what kind of city life they used to have. So these excavations have really proved a lot about our Indus Valley civilization. Then we have the topic artifacts. Now next archaeological source is the artifacts. So artifacts are objects made by human beings, especially one of cultural or historical interest. So you can see in the picture there are some artifacts or the pottery or some kind of arts that is made engraved on some of the utensils. These should tell us more about those time. So these objects refer to the work of art done by man in the past, like paintings, sculptures, pottery, ornaments, tools, weapons and textiles. The artifacts gives valuable information about the social and religious customs, food habits, clothing and means of entertainment of the people in the past. So what kind of people were they and what kind of life they led, this all was depicted on the artifacts that were found in the excavations. So children, in this term or unit 1 term we will study about only the archaeological sources, and the next we have the literary sources which will be continued for your second unit. So your second term course first unit, second term first unit will include only the archaeological sources, all the sources that we have studied up till artifacts. So this is all children for now. I hope you have loved to understand how we are learning about history. So it is very interesting to know. So till then we meet with the other part of the subject. It is goodbye for now.